thank you for tuning in to our Gateway Film Center Columbusland conversation. This one with John Kuhn, Artistic Director of Actors Theater. Thank you so much, John.
Thanks for having me.
Appreciate your time. You are dressed in traditional Shakespearean garb. I'm dressed more like one of the characters from Joss Whedon's Much Ado About Nothing adaptation. More modern,
more modern,
contemporary.
Much more modern, yes.
Now, obviously, this guy's having a lot of fun with this movie, you know, but it's not the first time that these kind of liberties have been taken with Shakespearean texts, right?
Not at all. Almost from the beginning, because the nature of the themes and issues dealt with in Shakespeare are so universal, mm-hmm. pretty much from the beginning, they started toying and tinkering and altering the script, playing with the structure, and then also setting it in different time periods. And that has a long tradition. And one of the great things about it, it really helps make the script, the material, the themes, the words, yeah. much more accessible, much more understandable, much more interesting to a modern audience.
Now, a lot of these actors, you know, there a lot of them are from Whedon's stable of favorites, his yeah. friends and people he's worked with frequently. They're not necessarily associated with Shakespeare. Does it hurt or does it help to be, you know, not classically trained, to approach it from a fresh perspective?
Talent is talent, and whether you have that background in classical theater or not, talent will out. And so if you're a very talented actor, you can handle the Shakespeare language. It's not that daunting. It's not that alien from the kinds of things you work on in other plays. No. But you have, I mean, good actors, I mean, you want to have good actors,
right.
always.
And does it help to be intimate with your cast? Like, these obviously, these are a cast of friends. Does
that,
it, in something like this, and something like Much Ado About Nothing, which is one of Shakespeare's best comedies, that probably
right.
adds a little something.
It
no?
always helps. I mean, when you look at some of the our tour directors over the time, you know, Hitchcock, Woody Allen, I mean, they tend to assemble a crew of people that they go back to over and over again, and there's a reason for that. You start developing a simplified vocabulary in terms of what your needs are in terms of the scene, and so, you want to work with talented folks, and he's got a great group of people gathered in this
yeah.
film.
Now, some of the things he's made a couple of changes. One is Hero does a lot less twirling.
Well, it's not a formal requirement of the role. There's again, it's a matter of interpretation. And with
doesn't
Shakespeare,
it say in Shakespeare's text says Hero enters twirling?
I'll grant that, but still, I mean, there's so many different ways to interpret that, and
yeah.
that as a character element, I think can go a lot of different ways. So I think the fact that there's less twirling might be actually a plus.
Okay. And also, you know, for people who are just seeing this for the first time, who are seeing a Shakespearean text performed for the first time, comedy, obviously, John, a great entry point for people unfamiliar with Shakespeare. I'm assuming that that Actors Theater, faces a lot of same challenges that this film will face, finding a new audience, right?
Well, that is always a challenge. The nature of what we do is to bring classical works, and primarily Shakespeare, to the Central Ohio audience. And because so much of our Western canon is based on his works, his ideas, his idea of what it means to be human, those works are important. And so, yeah, we're always working to find new venues, new audiences, new ways to get Shakespeare out there.
Well, terrific. Thank you very much for the
Thank
conversation.
You,
you can visit Actors Theater website. Thank you for watching the Gateway Film Center's YouTube channel. Shakespeare would tell you, don't introduce a weapon without using it. So...